What's up, gents? Dirtbag Gaming, the channel for casual raiders. Cheers. We're going over a arena video slash how to kind of play raid. Obviously, you can see this is not fully kitted out. I got some sevens in here, an eight. So we're really just waiting for next CVC. We have one extra upgrade. So one, two, three at sevens, one, two at eights. Everything else is 10. But I've been playing for a long time. I've been playing for about 2.5 years. And it's a huge deal. Like, why do you want to get your great haul up so much? Is because you're getting an extra 22%. Like, this is for rank five, but rank four, it's 20% extra HP on all your champions, 20% extra attack, 20% extra defense. Like, that goes a long freaking way in PvE content. An extra 2% is not going to make or break the game, but all of these extra stats in here are just so good. Like, this basically levels up all of your champions for everything. PvE, PvP, everything you need to kind of grow through the game, progression, you kind of need to level up this stuff. So I did a guide on a great haul video, which I'll link at the end here, on kind of what you're looking to do first, and then what you're looking to do kind of like towards the end, which if you could notice, I have a lot. Like, it's really just my red champions, because I don't have a lot of them, and my void defense champion. That's it. Everything else is kitted out pretty much as soon as possible. But let's go over to our PvP. How do we get that many rankings? Is we want to get up to gold as soon as possible. The fastest way to level up when you beat a champion is to get the gold bars. So when you guys are first starting out, whether you're beginning, middle, or end game, you get the most bars through gold. So you want to get up to gold one as soon as possible. How you get up to gold one is you just build a basic arena team and pick out your battles. So the basic arena team, let's go over that, is going to be really your starting champions. So I had a newer account when I first started, like maybe 6, 7, 8 months ago, and I leveled up to gold one as soon as possible. So if you guys want to go check that out, it's on my channel somewhere. It's just the free to play series from Dirtbag Nation. But everybody starts with your starting champion. Most of the time you're going to pick a starting champion of Kayle, which is probably going to be your Dark Elf champion. He just nukes like incredibly hard. He's got good passive and all that stuff. So this is going to be your nuker. That's kind of what you're building up towards, is having whatever your starting champion you pick be your nuker, right? So a nuker is just the person you build as much attack and crit rate and crit damage as possible can. Then you're going to try and want to get your spirit host as soon as possible before you get your free champion in there. And the reason you want to do her is because of this speed lead. So allies speed in all battles by 10%. That's you can farm her, the spirit host, but you're all going to get for free your Hecatomb. So Hecatomb is epic champion. It's a barbarian right here. So this is going to be the speed lead of 19% in all battles. Why you want her so much is because of the increased turn meter. So the easiest way to win a battle is have the most speed on your team. Fills turn meter of all allies by 15% and puts an increased speed buff on all allies for 2 turns. So you don't even have to book her out. You just have her as a speed lead, increased speed by 19%, and you put this out on her. So you make her your fastest champion. Then you need a debuffer. All right, so another barbarian that you're gonna wanna farm when you first start is the War Maiden. War Maiden is farmable, so you can actually go to one of the campaigns and you can farm for her, unless you pull her, you know, before then. But she's gonna be your AoE decreased defense. Now, if you have a Madame Ceres, obviously that's gonna be your number one choice, but she's gonna get you up to gold one pretty easily. Attacks all enemies, so you can actually build her out to be DPSer, but you want to increase accuracy and speed up as much as possible. The reason, because you want to book her out, so she'll have a 100% chance of placing a decreased defense on an AoE, so on all the champions, decreased defense. So the order goes high Khatoon, debuffer, nuker. That's it. Now you can have multiple boosters, which if you have an apothecary, which is another speed lead, another speed person, you bring in your apothecary, which is right here. I actually just, when I first got an apothecary, I just pulled as many green charges as I possibly could. He can actually boost your speed as well. So he's kind of, he has the same thing as High Khatoon, increased speed by 30% and increased turn meter by 15%. So it's basically the same as High Khatoon. But you can double it up. So you can go speed boost, debuff, nuke. Or you can have another nuker. Where if you have another person that you probably got, like a ninja or something like that, like everybody, I don't know if they still start with a free ninja, but a ninja basically is the free champion that is very, very good, especially when he first came out. So you can have a ninja come in and just kind of nuke down the team, freeze the team, do this fire damage, decrease attack, but you're mainly going to just freeze the team. If you freeze the team, you then have a whole nother round to nuke them down. All right, so this video is mainly going to be how to go up to, gold 5 and get as many gold bars as possible, but it's kind of turning into how to just get up to gold as soon as possible and save up as much gold bars for your Great Hall. So that's the gist of Arena. Now let's get into Arena. There's a couple teams that you want to have saved when you're playing in Arena. We're in Gold 5. If we just, obviously you're going to want to win these out as soon as possible. So anytime you see a one person team, just go in there, get your free rewards, and then keep moving on. Let's get a faster team here because this chick I was trying out, I had to actually regear her. So she should not be in there. But then this one, let's put in our main team, our main fast team, which is this one. So this is our go first main team, same concept. So I have speed booster, debuffer, CC champion, and nuker. So CC champion, if you guys have a basher, probably one of the best CC champions in the game. Reset their cooldown so that way they can only use their A1s. So this is what you're getting. You're getting 4 gold bars every time you win an arena. Times that by, or divided by 1,000. That's how many times you have to win to get a number 10 upgrade. So let's upgrade this. So these are the champions that we're seeing in gold 5. Usually they're a lot better than this. But when you're looking through your teams, you want to go through who do you think you can beat. This one obviously is a freebie. He's just kind of giving us a free win. So we're gonna go in there, we're gonna get our free win, and then we're gonna look for the next team. So now my Arbiter has like a 300 and I don't know, 20 or 30 speed. She's not that fast. So the only teams that I know I can beat are ones that don't have Arbiter in the lead. So like if I do this one, I'm gonna assume, right? Just knowing my Arbiter, I'm probably not gonna win this. If I win it, it's just a fluke. Watch. All right, so I am way faster than this Arbiter. So I should be able to win this one. But I don't wanna assume that I'm gonna win because I'm just gonna always assume that their Arbiter is faster. Unless I look at their team and it's like blues and greens or just champions that probably are not leveled up as much as mine are. All right, so we won that one. But let's take example this one. There's a block revive champion in there. So if I'm not fast enough, he's just gonna block revive me and then I'm not gonna be able to do anything. So again, this 10 spot that we just saw ahead of time, probably not the best teams that you could see in Arena. But we beat that either way. So let's just assume that all these other ones are faster than me. Anytime you see a Hegemon is basically made to stop your, to block your buffs, block your cooldown, block your skills. So there can be a stun Hegemon, there could be a super high DPS Hegemon, there could be somebody that just CCs the crap out of you before you even get to go. So anytime you see Hegemons on the team, you want to have immunity set, which block buffs or debuffs, or you want to have stone skin, kind of like a cardinal. So if I see a team like this is made to go first and just screw over the enemy team. So this guy's going to make everybody attack at the same time. It's a hassle. So I'm going to go with my defensive team that can actually take a hit and then keep going. So Siphi and Rotos is a really good combo. They can actually take away debuffs from your side. This Tormund team is going to help freeze the enemy team, especially with a Arbiter that she speed boosts, and then Tormund freezes the enemy team. But we're going to go more defensive, such as a Cardinal team, which is kind of down here. So this is our Cardinal Ghost second team. Now, if they die, that's the whole goal. So I want them to die. I want Cardinal to live, and I want my enemy team to die. The Ghost second team is what got me to Platinum a couple times, but it helps out in moving up in 3v3 a lot. So there you go, our whole team died. Cardinal's fine with stone skin. So we're gonna res them all back up. And then we have these guys speed tuned to go specifically where I need them to go. Arbiters first, then we have a speed boost and increased attack from our Seeker. Him attacking doesn't really matter. And then we have our Nuker. So our Nuker for us is this dude, who comes in and just nukes down the enemy team. Now, weak affinity with the red to blue. So I basically have to have Cardinal live through her, which I think we can, and then res up the team again. So most of the time you can have your nuker nuke down the enemy team. I did not because I wasn't prepared and I didn't put the best gear on our dude here. But that's basically what this team does, is it takes the hit, you expect your entire team to die, and then you come back and you just nuke the crap out of everybody. Boom, dead. You win. And that was a Hegemon team. So anytime I see a Hegemon team, mainly my go-to is going to be Cardinal or this team right here, which is my main team. One of my main teams, it's this one. Very defensive, very not going first. But if I just put this on auto, and you see Hegemon is going to come in. All right, so decreased attack on everybody. He probably doesn't have a lot of accuracy, so he didn't land any of his other stuff. But look at that. Provoke on everybody, stun on everybody. Freeze didn't really matter. We can try and kill this chick because she's the rezzer. Oh, there's two rezzers. We have Sile and the Void chick. But that's my go second team, is somebody that can CC like Tormund, the enemy team, but mainly be able to take the hit. So if you can take the hit and know that you can survive, that's your go second team, mainly for Hegemons. Now the other person you're going to see is a Tormund on the enemy team. So if you see a Tormund and you're playing your Arbiter, it's not going to go well. You're gonna get frozen. You're gonna be pissed because like they have a Tormund, and I was pissed for a very long time because of Tormund. You want to have somebody with an immunity set. So immunity set is gonna be the set that you put on you. It's a four-piece set that you're immune to all buffs. So what you do is you bring, I think I made a video on that where you bring, there's two cleansers that you can bring on your team to cleanse the Tormund buff, and then put up a block buff so that way Tormund stops, and then you debuff and then you nuke. So it's basically kind of like the same thing. I don't know if we have a Tormund on the other team. Yeah, right here. So it'd be something like this. So if you see a Tormund and you want to go an auto team, you would have your Arbiter go first. She would freeze your team. It doesn't really matter. And then you bring in, where is she? This chick, Sky Touch Shaman. So Sky Touch Shaman has a block buffs and remove all debuffs. So she's the one in immunity set. Everybody else doesn't have to be immunity set. It's just her. So she's an immunity set where she doesn't get frozen. So you start the battle, your chick is faster, so she would boost everybody up. She then would go She's at 212 speed, so she's really slow. But she would then cleanse your entire team and put up a block buffs. So there's no more freeze. Then you would have your debuffer, and then you would have your nuker. So it would be a team set up kind of like this. And you would set it up where she would use her A3, she would use her A2, she would use her A3, and then she would use her A3. And that would just win any tournament team that you have that doesn't have an arbiter as a lead. So again, these guys are way too fast for our chick here, but maybe we have another person, which is Hakeem Smash Lord. This guy. I don't know what his speed's at. 270. All right. And then our madame is 290. All right, so that won't work. But we'll do something like Drago. Where's Drago? Drago. Or Lydia, what's her speed? Her speed's probably 290 or something. Why doesn't it show her speed? That's so annoying. I don't know what her speed is. And then Trunda, whatever. So let's do some of this. So Arbiter is going to speed boost. We're going to get frozen. Tormund's gun or Hakeem Smashler is going to cleanse everybody, which he has an immunity set, so he's able to be immune of everything. We're going to debuff the enemy team, and then we have a nuke, which just comes in and just nukes everybody. Unless you have a Duchess, which probably has like 500 resistance. But that is the gist of the team that you want to go against Tormund. Is you have a cleanser kind of like and dead. You have a cleanser, Skathed the Shaman, she's an epic. Or if you get lucky, you can bring in Hakeem Smashlord, which was, I think, literally my first legendary champion that I had on my account. But hopefully we won this one. Oh, nope, frozen, just kidding. I forgot there was a Tormund still alive on the enemy team. So now everybody is super debuffed. I need Hakeem Smashlord to cleanse everybody again, which probably won't happen. Now, there's no, what's her name on the Lydia? There's no Lydia on the other team. So if I try and res, at least I'll be able to res, unless Warlord resets my cooldowns, which I think he already did. Yeah, so I have a two-turn cooldown. So I should be able to. Nope, just kidding. So this could go longer than I thought. Yeah, that was pointless. I wasn't gonna beat the warlord that had the 3-turn cooldown, reset cooldown. So, but that was the gist. So that was the whole point of being here. If I had my madame, which is made for PvP, not my Draco, then you could have something like this or this be your team. And you can set it up, make sure they're speed tuned. So she's first, she's second to cleanse everything, she's third, and she's fourth. And then that would nuke down the enemy team. So then you have normal teams like this, where as long as your speed is good, then your speed team could beat this, your speed team could beat this. This team would be something like a defensive team. So you have nobody to cleanse the freezes. So you would run a Tormund or a freeze team like this. Or you can start building a very defensive team like this. Anytime I see two Rezzers on the enemy team, I try and bring my Mortar Macabre in there because he's the block revive. If you have anybody on your team that has a block revive, that's a champion that you want to throw into Mortar Macabre position. Other than that, these three are just made there, are made to keep Mortar Macabre alive just so he can do his block revive. If you have a like a, what's his name? Anybody that has a block revive skill is going to be good for that position. I want to level up this guy to really bring him in here and kind of make the block revive present, which is, I don't, he might actually be out. So he's, of course they don't have him. It's the Blood Gorge guy, the undead dude that block revives everybody. Foley, fuck it. You bring Foley in. So Foley would be the guy that is the block revive instead of Mortar Macabre, where he would be the guy to come in and just block revive the enemy team. Once you block revive either their DPSer or anybody, then you kind of win the match. So if I bring in, I don't know, on this team, this right here, who's an easier one? So like, you could bring a bomb team in there. That was pretty fun. So a defensive team for a newer player would be something like a Seeker, Sandlash Survivor, one of my favorite champions right here, a Rezzer, so any type of Rezzer that you have. The Old Lady is a very good arena defensive Rezzer. You have Cardinal, obviously, but Godseeker is a very good one. Obviously, the Duchesses, then we're getting more into the legendary type champion. Sile could be a good one. Your Chick is probably going to be your go first team, so you don't really, probably not really going to use her. But let's just throw out a Duchess. So we have a Duchess, and then our Block Revive champion. So the Block Revive champion will throw Foley out here. But it would be something like this. So if Foley doesn't get nuked down, if he does, he'll hopefully just get res back up from Duchess. But here we go. All right, so we got nuked down from their nuker Kale, but get res back up, which I don't know why we didn't res back up. And my Foley, I don't think has any gear on him right now. I love making videos that I'm just not prepared, and most of my champions are swapping gear out left and right. All right, so who are we gonna, going to try and provoke their DPSer. And he's frozen. Or asleep. I didn't know Froli can be slept. I thought that was one of his things that he's immune to. Alright. Yeah, he's not geared out because he doesn't have like any HP. So let's see if he does anything. Let's try and provoke this guy. Dead. And then block revive on any one of these guys. Cool, so block revive, so basically it's game. But that would be something. So now Mortar Macabre is an HP type champion, so he's a crap ton of HP, and he's in Swift Parry set, so he has a chance to not die. That's the go-to kind of block revive guy. The other guy, the Blood Gorge guy, I wanna build him up because I wanna make a video on him, but he would be another block revive guy that I wanna test out. So that's kind of like the defensive type team, like these three right here, or just these two, and if you bring Cardinal in there, it's even better to kind of get res back up, take the hit, and then keep going. So we don't have a Duchess. Let's just assume you don't have a Duchess. Who else can we bring in this spot? Godseeker, very good one. Who else? Cardinal, obviously we already went over. Any type of res that you can build, resistance, HP, or speed. Like I said, this Chick is very good. What's his name? She could be pretty annoying. Kaden. Gorgorob, one of the best early game. That's mainly it. But this guy could be also another block revive dude. So if you have that and you do a team kind of like this, it would be super annoying as a defensive team, or Godseeker. So if you do something like this, now I don't have him booked out, but he's got an A1 that block revives and he puts an extra hit if they have any debuffs, enemy teams killed by the skill cannot be done. So place an extra hit if the target has any debuffs. So, you would need somebody on your team to place a debuff. So maybe instead of Godseeker, you could put this Chick on there. She is a Rezzer and puts out a debuff. Or her if she has enough accuracy to put out this debuff. Let's try this just kind of for shits and giggles. So let's go. I probably don't have any deep gear on any of these people. definitely not him. I probably took all of his gear off on him. And he's frozen, so it really doesn't matter. But we're just, look at that. We survived with no gear because of Sandlash Survivor and Seeker. So I'm surprised this guy's not dead yet. And now he's dead. Okay. So we have our Rezzer. But again, no gear. So she's super slow. But we Rez back up. Still super slow. So I can't do it. Oh my god. Okay. So again, you have to be geared. If you don't have any gear, kind of defeats the purpose. But this would be a team. This would be a team that you would try out for a defensive type team. Because it's super annoying to face. You can make your Ryan be a shit ton of defensive resistance and HP. And she just will never die, especially with these two on your team. Seeker and Sandlash Survivor, they have such good passives in the game that you just don't die. Yeah, so again, I can't really show you that team if they're not geared. But you would gear them out, you would get them ready, and then you would just play. Shit. So, end game. And then if you're more of a late game type person, obviously you're going to have teams like this that, let's say you're not first, and you really want to build a team that's going to be your go second team. There's just going to be so many options for you to choose from. So we have this team. We have this team. This is my main team. We have this team. We have this team. We have this team. Valkyrie with 700 accurate resistance. This team, which is pretty much this team. And then two Rezzers. Block or just don't kill them, and then that team. Sandlash Survivor, I think, is one of my favorites. So this team right here would be just a super annoying team to face. Two Rezzers, resistance, and then a block revive champion. So if Mortimer gets hit, he has a potential chance to block revive one in the enemy team. And once you start block reviving the enemy team, it's kind of like game. Like, the enemy team is either going to quit, like right there. So I should block revive one of the main people on their team. Now, if you block revive for DPS, it's basically they're going to quit. So this is a good team to put as your defense, because when you're faced by normal people, they usually do it manual or they do it auto, but then they stop and try and beat you. And if their fucking DPS gets one-shotted by Mortar Macabre, they're probably going to go up to the right here, hit pause, and then just quit. And that's the whole point of a defensive team. So those are kind of like the teams that you're really looking to build. One is going to be your main team, your go-first Arbiter team. The second one's going to be a go-second team that you know that probably Sandlash Survivor, Seeker, people that you know are going to survive the hit. And then your third team is going to be like a CC slash you don't give a shit team. So the go second team, it's very hard to do on auto if you have a Cardinal. But if you have a manual team with Cardinal, it's easy, like especially for 3v3. So let's say we're facing somebody, I don't know, like this team. So I'm looking at this team and I have a Tormund, so I'm going to use my like go second CC team, which is this team right here. So this would be my first team. Then the second team I can use as my Arbiter team, because I'm going to be faster. There's no Tormund on the enemy team. And this last team, it's a very tanky team. So I can use, there's no Rezzers at all. So I can literally do any one of my other teams, but I'll probably do a team like, I guess this. Because I do have a Rezzer, I have a block revive, I have a counter attack. So that'd be something like that. But my go second team would be for a fast team that I know I'm gonna lose to. So this would be my 3v3 choice for this team. Now, if you have another setup where there's a couple fast teams, let's say this one right here is a good example. So this team, I'm going to assume that I'm going to go second with. So for this, I would bring my Cardinal team in here. So my Cardinal would face that go first team. This team, I would use my first team, which would be my Arbiter team. So Arbiter would go up here. She would be my go first team. I would definitely, hopefully beat this team. This team would be my go second team. So I have one super fast team, one Cardinal team that I know is going to be perfect for, and this team would be my go second, tanky, block revive, go second team. So it looks something like this. So it'd be go first, and then it would be super tanky go second team right here. And then the third one would be the Cardinal team, which is kind of like this. So something like this, right? Let's test it out. And this is kind of what you're going to be using for mainly your PvP matchups, because you get to choose, as well as your 3v3 matchups, because you want to get up to gold one for your 3v3 and kind of just stay there forever for CVC points, because every time you beat 3v3, you get like 650 points or something. Like, it's a lot. Times that by X amount of games for the next 3 days. It's a lot of points for CVC. Again, we win that one. Now this one is going to be our tanky go second team. So we're trying to freeze as many as possible. And then we have our DPSer all the way to the right, which just hits super friggin' hard. There you go. And then we basically won that one. And then finally, the last team is our go second team, which as long as we win 2 out of 3 of the matches, we're happy in 3v3, because that's going to get us points. It's going to grow us. That's going to get us to the next level. So there you go. We won 2 out of 3 so far. That last one, if we win that one, it's a bonus. I want to put my best two teams up that I know I can beat going into the match. I'm not going to play the match if I know I can't beat them. So let's see if we can beat this team. This team is pretty fucking hard. Look at that nuke. Now we need the Madame to die, which she did not die. All right, can we strip all of this? That's the question. So if we strip all of these, sweet. So then we'll res up. This guy's going to go. And then let's see if we can nuke this guy. Boom, look at that. Easy. Easy. And that is the goal. So we have a level 1 seeker in our team. So guys, let me know in the comments below what you guys think about PvP. I definitely love PvP in the game. I definitely want to make more PvP videos. But it all comes down to starting with what we talked about early in the video, which is like getting the first arena team and then farming champions and getting the second arena team and so on and so on. So guys, appreciate it. Good luck. Join Discord if you haven't already. We're doing account takeovers. We have gear cleansing events. We're doing account giveaway or account takeover next month, I believe, in June. So join the Discord if you haven't already. You have to be a part of that. And then obviously like and subscribe to the video. So good luck, guys. Appreciate it. And we'll see you in another video soon.